grandpa loved music, and we prepared two songs for him. One is grandpa really loved trio music, and it's a Catholic song called Bajo Nuevo. So we're gonna sing that, and then with grandpa so big in the Trujillo movement, I thought maybe we could sing Alabaré too. Okay.
Gracias, quiero darte. Throughout all of our life, we are accompanied by the grace of the Lord, His presence, the presence of the saints, and especially our Blessed Mother. And she promises to be with us at every moment and this moment. So we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
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 The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, who was born among us, lived among us, died, accepting the weight of our sins, and then rose, so that we might be a people of hope, be with you always.
And with your spirit.
With your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Luis died with Christ and rose with him to new life, that he now share with him eternal glory.
All bears, please.
Yeah.
us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant, Luis Maldonado, to be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. When people are saying, peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, for that day will overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of light, children of day. We are not of the night or darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and be sober. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who fear the Lord.
Blessed are they who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways. For you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored.
Blessed are they who fear the Lord.
Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the recesses of your home. Your children like olive plants around your table.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are they.
reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man going on a journey called his servants and entrusted his possessions to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to a third 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. Immediately the one who received 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5. Likewise, the one who received 2 made another 2. But the man who received 1 went off and dug a hole in the ground and buried his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 talents came forward, bringing with him an additional 5. He said, "Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I would like to begin by thanking all of you family members on behalf of my dad, because he has gave me some instructions. He said he wanted me to thank you for the visits, the prayers, the cards, and the well wishes, the blessings that he had received these past years from all of you who came to see him. He was especially moved by his great-grandson, Jesse, because at Christmas time, Jesse gave me a candy cane. And he says to me, "Papa, I want you to give this to Abuelo and tell him that the red means that there is sadness and sorrow, and because Jesus died on the cross. But the white means that there is joy because Jesus rose from the dead. But when you eat the candy cane and you suck on it, all the red disappears and then it's all white." So, from a 6-year-old. Then the next time he buys a candle, I don't know if he bought it or not, if he just took it. But here. And he brought it to Abuelo, and he lit the candle, and he presented it to my dad. My dad was bedbound, as you know. And he said, "Abuelo, this is for you so that when you go, this candle will light your way." Isn't that something? It's beautiful. It's beautiful. And my dad was so grateful, and he just wanted to express his gratitude to all of you for the many blessings that you bestowed upon him at his time of need. He was not alone. He was not alone. We have come together today to pay our last respects and to honor Abuelo as we prepare to bring him to his place of rest. I find this to be a bitter, sweet moment. I say bitter because we are going to miss him terribly. The majority of us have known him our entire lives. It pains us. And we are experiencing deep sorrow because someone whom we have come to love so much will no longer be with us on this earth. We find comfort in knowing that, as St. Paul says, we are children of the light. We are children of the light. And we hope in our Lord. And we know that because of our Lord, there is a resurrection.
and so there is sweetness. Part of the sweetness of it all is that he is free. Free from the imprisonment that he has been in the past 6 years or so. That prison guard called Parkinson's crippled his body, but could not capture his mind or his spirit. To the very end, his mind was clear, and he turned to God for strength and faith and hope in the freedom that he had coming. A couple of weeks ago, he talked with me about his dying and the songs he wanted for his mass. He said to me that he was going to get a new life, and he wanted to celebrate with us at this mass. St. Paul says that death comes upon a person like labor pains come upon a pregnant woman. He says we cannot escape death, and that is true. But a pregnant woman has 9 months to prepare for that day and the new life coming. And Abuelo had a very strong faith. He was able to prepare. He knew that his moment was coming soon, and he welcomed it. He never indicated that he was afraid in any way. He told me he was looking forward to the new life he was going to receive. So that just knowing that should lift our spirits and make us, I think, give us a reason to celebrate and to be happy for him. Correct? Amen?
Amen.
Right. Our God granted him a tremendous blessing as a result of Parkinson's disease. Not that the disease was a blessing, but the fact that because of the disease, he was able to prepare himself, and he did it so very well. At the same time, he taught my sister Millie and me how to live and how to die with a heart filled with hope and love, humble and trusting in God. He prayed daily and listened to the Mass daily. He told us stories and jokes and sometimes sang to us or recited poetry that he had learned when he was a young man. In the 4 years that we cared for our father, he never complained, not even one time, not even once. I know there were moments when he felt humiliated because he could not take care of his own personal needs. He never expected that his son and his daughter would have to help him that way. But he always expressed gratitude. Always thanked me. I don't know if he thanked you, but he always thanked me. You might may have been a little rough. But at this moment, Millie and I, on behalf of Millie and myself, I'd like to express some gratitude to our spouses, to Manuel and Mickey, because of their patience and their understanding, we were able to care for our father. They had to put their lives on hold as well. We chose the Gospel of the Talents for Abuelo's funeral mass because it was befitting of him. When Abuelo was a young boy in Puerto Rico, his father died. He described to me the building that he lived in with his mother and his siblings as a garage with a dirt floor. They were very poor. He said that at that young age, the priest and the sisters of their church, San Blas de Illescas, after speaking with his mother, embraced him and welcomed him to be a part of the church, to hang out at the church, so to speak. I believe that is where his seed of faith germinated and grew to become as strong as it did. I believe that this is where he received his God-given talents, like the servants in the gospel. Like the servant in the gospel, he used those talents to the best of his ability. God gave him spiritual talents that he used to help others grow in their faith. As a boy at his church, he would serve as altar server and learn the songs of his faith. He also enjoyed ringing the church bells. He grew older and his faith strengthened. He became more involved in passing on the faith. In 1949, when he moved to New York, where he initially moved, he found a job working in the fields, gathering vegetables for a canning company that grew their own vegetables. And he was working in the field. Well, he liked going to Mass. And one Sunday he was at Mass and the priest was by himself. He had no server. So my dad just walked up and started helping the priest. He just walked up and started helping the priest as a server. Well, it so happened that after Mass, this gentleman approached him and he says, "I think I've seen you before. Where do you work?" And he told him the name. This man happened to be the owner of the business, of the company. And he says, "Well, I like what you did. So tomorrow you don't go to the fields. Tomorrow you come to my factory." And see how God blesses? When you show your faith, when you live your faith, God blesses us. When he and Mom brought us to live in Orem, Ohio, one of the first things they did was become members of this chapel, Sacred Heart Chapel. It was on Vine then. In this chapel, he became very active in various ways, volunteering wherever he was needed. He was also a member of a traveling Presidio group of men who would bring the good news of Presidio, the Presidio movement, to places like Rochester, New York, or Lansing, Michigan, or Youngstown. With his gift of singing, he led people in worship of our God and participation at Mass. He was drafted by the Legion of Mary to be their spiritual director. At home, he treated us, his children, with compassion and love. And then the same with his grandchildren and great-grandchildren. He was always very good to us. And he and our mother would bring us together every day for evening prayer. He was always sacrificing for us, making sure we had everything we needed. As a boy, I remember him leaving for work to work at the steel mill late at night. And it was very cold, the winters here. And the clothing was not very warm, but he never failed to go to work. He, like many of our fathers, made things happen for us. He and my mother were very welcoming at home as well. Oftentimes, I would get up in the morning and come downstairs, and there might be people sleeping on the floor or on a cot in our home. Our good Lord also granted him physical talents. He told me that when he was a boy, he and his friends would run a race from El Puente de las Calabazas to downtown Cuamo, which years later would become the 13-mile marathon that is hosted every February in Cuamo. In his youth, he also played much baseball, a sport he would continue to play here in Lorain with the City Leagues. He also loved dancing. He joined the Arthur Murray School of Dancing and oftentimes danced at charitable events. He was also the neighborhood chauffeur, taking people to various appointments, to school or to church. With his physical talents, with his physical ability, his involvement in these various areas would open the door for him to be able to witness his faith. So he did it both ways, with his spiritual gifts and with his physical gifts. In my entire life, I never heard my father use foul language. or talk badly about anybody. It would be wonderful if we all had the opportunity to share an experience we may have of Abuelo, how he touched your life. But because of the pandemic protocol, it is impossible for us to hear each other's testimonies or witness to Abuelo's life as we are accustomed to do so, like at funeral wake services. But my son Louis, who could not be here, he lives in New York, and it was impossible for him to come. He wrote and posted a note on Facebook, and I would like to share it with you. He said, "I vividly remember being 3 years old and asking Mom what it meant to have a heart of gold. It was the 70s, and Neil Young's Heart of Gold played incessantly on the radio. My inquisitive mind just couldn't make sense of it. How could anyone have a heart made of gold? Her answer was simple and perfect. Your abuelo has a heart of gold. That was all the explanation I needed. Even at that very young age, I understood immediately and completely. I am forever grateful and truly blessed to having this man as my grandfather. He was always loving and joyful, with a song in his heart that he would share with the world with his beautiful baritone voice. I often credit him for my love of music and dance. But his most profound lessons were the ones he taught by example. Kindness, humility, gentility, charity, and devotion to God, one's family, and one's neighbor. He always showed us the way, even to the very end. His mind was sharp as a tack, but Parkinson's disease took all of his mobility. He accepted being a prisoner in his own body, only expressing love through his quick wit and sense of humor, never complaining of his situation. This at a time where so many are complaining about having to wear a mask or other minor inconveniences brought on by the pandemic. In doing so, he left us with his final, most powerful lessons: strength, courage, gratitude, and acceptance of the crosses we must bear. We will miss Abuelo tremendously. His vessel no longer dwells on this earth, but his spirit and legacy live on through us, his family. May we remember his lessons and pass them on to the next generations. Our world greatly needs them." Our Lord gives each of us our own set of blessings and talents that he knows we are capable of fulfilling or making fruit. Our Father, our Abuelo, is a witness to this gospel. He recognized the talents that God gave him and made them fruitful. Our God granted him a pain-free, peaceful death and then said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Come share your master's joy."
Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Dad received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Our brother and father was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Many people die by violence, war, famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
The family and friends of our dad seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our Father. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Lord God, giver of peace, healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Río del agua viva, 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 río del agua viva
acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Luis, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, with Edward, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Luis Maldonado, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will be raised up in the flesh. But he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed sisters and brothers too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all. Lamb of God,
take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
This is the moment for Catholics where we express most profoundly our communion and our faith in the real presence of the body and blood of Christ. And so if you don't share that faith with us, or simply aren't going to receive today, I simply ask that as we come by that you would cross your arms on your chest, that we will pray for spiritual communion. If you are receiving, we'd ask that as we approach, you take the mask off, then receive, and then replace your mask.
So nothing shall
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Luis, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we must reverently bury the body of our brother Luis. Let us pray with confidence to God, in whose sight all of creation lives, that he will raise up in holiness and power his mortal body and command his soul to be numbered among the blessed. May God grant him a merciful judgment, deliverance from death, pardon of sin. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, carry him home to be at peace with the Father, and may he rejoice forever in the presence of the Eternal King and in the company of all the saints. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Luis in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in this life, both the spiritual and the physical blessings. They are signs to us of your goodness, your faithfulness, and of our sharing in communion with all the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and comfort and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Amores de muchos colores, me gustan.
ángeles de los campos en la primavera, de colores son los pajarillos que vienen de afuera, de colores es el arco iris que vemos lucir, y por eso los grandes amores de muchos colores me gustan a mí. Por eso los grandes amores de muchos colores me gustan. De colores, 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 de colores.
Cristo Rey,
que viva,
que viva Cristo Rey,
que viva,
que viva Cristo Rey,
que viva.
Martin. Bears.
Yeah.
I can't see them.
Okay. Yeah. I just talked to Louis. He's he was crying. He was still crying.
Honor detail. Hey, Zan.
That was a pretty mass, wasn't it?
Beautiful.
Proof.
not locking, so they can't put it on here. Brother, they can't put it here.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have assembled here today to offer our final, lasting tribute of respect and affection to our departed comrade. As the years roll by, we note with sorrow and regret that the ranks of veterans diminish. One by one, our comrades leave us. One by one, our comrades pass into the great beyond. The United States Army veteran of the greatest generation is gone, but the bond with us will never be broken. In an hour that ye seek not, when the final summons comes, no one disobeys. Grant our comrade a safe passage from this earth of wild beauty to places unknown. For those of us who remain, it is a time to mourn, a time to heal, and a time to reflect upon the memories of the love that we shared. Gathered here beside the final resting place of our Army brother, let us heed the words of our chaplain.
The Lord our God, who saves us without end, whose mercy is everlasting. Thou art the refuge of our soul, the strength of our life, and our portion forever. We come to thee, we trust in thee. Let us not be confounded nor dismayed. God of battle, author of peace, as our comrades depart to be with thee, we march on with broken ranks. Help us to be faithful to their memories and loyal to the spirit that animated them. Help us to perpetuate their memories by noble consecration to their ideals. In comradeship, loyalty, and devotion, may we continue worthy of your sacred memory. O Lord, in thy goodness and mercy, grant unto the renewed friends comfort and consolation. Prepare, O God, we pray thee, our minds, hearts for this life with all its troubles and responsibility, for death with all its mystery and solemnity, and bring us finally through thy grace and through the united comradeship of everlasting life, world without end.
Amen. Praise him.
Hey!
In the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope and eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother. Together, may we meet Christ Jesus when he, who is our life, appears in glory. You are blessed by my Father, says the Lord. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Granted our Father, sleep here in peace until you awaken him to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Because God has chosen to call dead from this life to himself, commit his body to the earth, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our mother, our father, our grandfather to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace them in peace and raise up his body. The last day. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you peace.
Christ have mercy.
Give peace to Luis forever. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bless those who mourn and are in pain. Bless Luis' family and friends who gather around him today. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray in the words that Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
And let the perpetual light shine upon him.
May he rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.
Through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. May Almighty God bless you, Father.
Amen.
All the friends that were able to be here, and for the prayers and support to the family. I'd like to thank the pallbearers for their help today. I'm going to stay here to make sure that everything's taken care of. I haven't seen the guys from the cemetery, but I hope they're going to be back here soon. So I'll make sure that everything's taken care of. Thank you very much for letting me serve you.